What's going on, everybody? It's Treeb from Treeb Talks here. We are officially 5 weeks in our NFL picks, locks, and upsets of the week. And the boys have remained consistent. We got a consistent room in the building. We got Colg in the building. Colg, how you doing, brother?
I'm doing great. How are you doing today, Treeb?
I'm doing great. Your Steelers weren't able to play this week.
Yeah, that's... I'm just saying, I would have had one extra point. I'm just saying, man, that might come back to bite me in the ass at the very end of the year, but, or I guess it wouldn't. It might still happen if the season's not canceled.
You know what I think we should do as a vote, just right here, right now? I don't think on that game we should repick that game. I think we should go based off of what we picked on that video.
Things might change. Man, I think. I mean, I'm still gonna pick Pittsburgh.
I think it got flexed so we could flex it to
little 2020 back. Rona curse on that pick. Got to sprinkle some bad juju. Maybe not. All right. And if you're watching this, maybe comment down below what you think on what we should do on that Texans. I mean, on that Titans Steelers game. Larry, you're in the building. Cardinals let you down 2 weeks in a row.
But guess what? You know what's good about this one? We already knew that this one was going to happen.
Yeah, you had a little precursor.
I already knew the whole week. I just knew. The Panthers are one of those teams that always beats us. It doesn't matter who they have. It's just they do.
Yeah, it's like your Chargers for us. The Chargers always beat us.
Anybody
else in the league.
And it's like my cousin was talking to me about this earlier, and he says, like, the Lions are one of those teams, too, who we lost to, are one of those teams that we fight with, and it's either last possession, either team wins type of scenario. The Panthers are the complete opposite. They just dominate us, and then we put up garbage touchdowns at the end and make it look somewhat close, but they just kicked their ass the whole week.
Also, how'd that L taste in crew fantasy? Tree from Creep Talks.
Well, you know,
moves on to 4-0 after a dominant victory over...
You literally won by 0.6.
By the way, I'm going to flash up right here this screenshot of what Bryce's fantasy football name is.
It's the Italian Stallions.
I know, but I have a screenshot of what it was prior, or what it says.
Yeah, well, there's two parts.
I know, I'm not actually going to show it, but it's a good one. But, yeah, 1 point fantasy victory for me. I mean, the crew league's fun because it's an eight-man league.
I want it. Took off because one of those jet sweeps was not a pitch forward, it was a handoff straight to Tyreek Hill, and it's in the backfield, so that to me is not a touchdown. How does a quarterback get a touchdown off a handing off the ball to a receiver and the receiver doing all the work and get to the pylon? That to me is somebody in the backfield behind the line of scrimmage should be counted as a runner.
I got one answer for you, and that's just the way she goes.
Yeah. Made me loser.
Anyway, we got another guy in the building, and as of right now, it's 12:52. The one day has gone by. You're officially one day into being 22 years old, Cam. How are you feeling today?
Normal.
Normal?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy your birthday? I know you got Madden 21. There's a lot of Madden 21 haters out there. What's your kind of first initial thoughts on the game so far?
I haven't played it too much to really say there, Captain.
What have you noticed anything different? I know that's kind of been
it's
the...
more smooth, more real, it feels like.
Is it actually fun playing in those high school games in the face of the franchise? Because I knew that was something that they've hyped up.
No, not really. It's just like playing an all rookie, and you can just like run through everyone. I ran the ball every single time. I didn't even throw a single pass in the high school games. So
just run through hoes out there.
It's pretty easy.
Julian Edelman cost you.
Yeah, he's just a stupid guy. We need to get rid of him. He's old. He's not really that good. Never really was that good. Brady made him good.
I think Belichick's fed up with him, too.
Yeah. I mean, like, he every single week he's dropped at least 3 passes. So, I mean, like, we don't need those.
You don't need guys like that in your offense.
Yeah, we don't need that. We don't want that. You got to get out of there.
And for the second week in a row, we got special guest Wyatt in the building. Bro, it's good to see you. How are you?
What's up, man? It's good to be back.
Last time you went on a little tangent last week about being the best side of the Mississippi, and And Patrick Jackson, who's one of our good friends from the UK, he said that description really kind of broadened his mind on how us Americans say somebody is really good at something. He said, he didn't know that people use the Mississippi River as a, I guess, way of saying somebody is good on that side of it.
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
So your tangent was felt by the people, so hopefully you got some more of that locked and loaded. I like your Sabu shirt, too, by the way.
Thank you. Very nice Taboo shirt.
Taboo?
Not Taboo shirt, but Sabu shirt. I got at ProWrestlingTees.com.
Not sponsored.
A little sponsored. Shout out.
Yeah.
Little
not shout. Sponsored. Good luck finding a t-shirt under $20, but very nice.
Especially when you include shirts.
They are nice shirts, though.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. It is time to dive in to your favorite time of the week, and that is the points reveal for this week. Now, usually I go first. Actually, before I get into going first, Wyatt, I gotta know, do you know how many points you had last week? No, you don't got that calculated? All right.
No.
All right, so I will go first. And I will say, ladies and gentlemen, Treeb is on a roll. Unfortunately, I don't think it's a good enough roll to put me back into the race, but that's all right. We did hit our lock with the Seahawks, and we did hit our upset as well to give us a total of 11 points to bring us to 33 points. So
you did it for Fitz.
Yeah, so we got a Fitz score. I know that's usually Larry's thing, getting a score for Fitz, but that's what we did. I found my upset. I was kind of trying to stall for time to find my upset. The Browns. Picked the Browns to upset the Cowboys.
They did.
And they fucked around and upset the boys, so I was very, very pleased about that.
It was a very nice one from the Browns.
And that was a fun game to watch, too. That was super fun. All right, next we got Colg, I believe.
All right, so I got my lock correct, but my upset wrong.
No points about that. But.
And I didn't do as good as last week, and I didn't really do good last week. And I only got 7 points.
Ooh.
So I'm sitting at 38.
38. So Treeb slowly but surely kind of making the trek back. We're 6 points behind. So now we got the battle for first place. I see Cam's kind of eyeing Fitz's sheet over there. So we got Fitz going first. He was in second place. Actually, you know what?
I think me and Fitz were tied for second.
Yeah,
place.
Tied for second.
Yeah,
tied
you
for
guys
second.
Are tied for
so
second.
You know,
yeah, so
let's go I think it's sure. only fair that we stay tied.
I like that idea.
I got 7 as well.
Oh, what?
I had a bad week.
Man, I
came in here and I pulled a tomfoolery, you know, you gotta put on the shrew sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Dude, I thought, Thursday.
I got 7 points. I missed my upset. Detroit pulled a close one against the Saints. I was just kind of trying to take a shot with them like you gotta do with this new rule we got. So I missed there, got the Packers, and only got 7. So.
Yeah, man, I had a feeling before you were even here. I told Cameron, I was like, man, I have a feeling he might have had like a record breaking week, but
no.
He didn't.
He had a tough one.
All right, and the leader and the birthday boy, Cam, what do you got?
You know, everyone didn't think I was going to do so good this year in picks, but
he's going to say that every single week.
Man, I really love being the leader with another monster amount of wins with 13.
No way. Is that the most all year?
I got
for
my
us?
Upset and my log right. I only got 2 or 3 games wrong, ladies and gentlemen. And I double checked just to make sure. And man, it wasn't a monster week coming in with 45 points and God. Damn, do I love being in first place.
Oh, man, so you have the record for most points in a week at the moment.
I can't help but feel like I'd be the second best person off the table if I came prepared.
If you came, you think so?
Maybe. I feel I'm almost sure I picked the Browns last week.
Oof.
It was a...
That was a great upset.
It was a good pick.
Yep.
Putting up 11, Cam putting up 13. Cameron, so far running away with it.
I am running away with this championship belt. You can call me the champ today, ladies and gentlemen.
Babies. If you ate a baby and you're not a gentleman, Cameron wants nothing to do with you.
Nope.
All right, so now that we got the scores out of the way, we got the Thursday night game between the Bucs and the Bears. And it's about time we got kind of a decent Thursday night game. It's not the Jets and whoever played last week, the Jets Broncos. And the Broncos. That game actually ended up being a lot better than it had any business being. I think it was because it was against two bad teams, but the Bucs and the Bears shouldn't be terrible. I'm going to start off with you, Fitz. What do you got?
I'm taking the Bucs. I like Brady. He came back and fought for that win. Herbert came out throwing dots to receivers that weren't really known in their offense for the Chargers. They're up, I think, 17 on Brady, but Brady just threw 5 TDs after throwing his one pick 6. And I think Brady's going to come back on the short week and take on the Bears. I think Trubisky sees the field in the third quarter. Foles is going to struggle in the first half and get benched.
I think that's kind of the... common trend for Foles. Maybe we'll see him later on in the season. Wyatt, who do you got?
I also have Brady and his Buccaneers. I think they're going to expose the Bears even worse than the Indianapolis Colts did last week. And it's going to be just by the books, Brady.
By the books, Brady. The BBB. Colch, what do you got?
I had Tom Brady on fantasy, man,
yes.
And I liked it. And I think he's going to do the same exact thing, so I'm going to have to go with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, Phil. All
right, Cameron, who do you got?
I'm going to have to go with the Buccaneers, ladies and gentlemen, as well.
And that's our first Starframe! $5 charity of your choice.
And that is because Treeb will also take Tampa Bay. And that is our 23rd. Starframe
of the season.
I like it.
Wow, through 5 weeks.
Yep, Treeb's keeping only stats.
Only two away from having a five star frame average.
Wow. Damn.
That's wild.
Quick maths.
Insane. Next up, we got the Bills and the Titans. This game's tough, man. And I think it's just as tough as how the Steelers and the Titans were. And, you know, I think if the Titans ended up playing the Steelers and they lost to the Steelers, I would feel a lot more confident playing the Bills. But, you know, after kind of getting that week of rest, not having to play the Steelers, I think the Titans are still kind of involved in this matchup. I think there's still some questions in this matchup. However, I'm still going to take the Buffalo Bills. And one thing I really want to address before we move on to the next person is that I will completely eat crow right now and say that Josh Allen is a good quarterback.
Thank you. About time.
I have said ever since he came to the league, that I didn't like Josh Allen. I didn't like what he had. I thought he was just a big, strong-arm QB, and everything that he did was pure scheme. But I think the Bills found their franchise quarterback in Josh Allen. So I'm going to say I was wrong about him. Colg, who do you got?
You know, I was wrong about him, too. I said that I didn't really like him, but they put on a clinic, and I think they continue to do that against the Titans because, you know, they haven't had practice, really, because of COVID.
Yeah.
You know, and maybe if they're still sick from that, this game might not even happen. I don't know how that would really work, but... they'd have to play, like, on Tuesday or something. But I'm going to pick the Bills.
All right, Wyatt, what do you got?
I'm going to pick the Bills as well. Bills Mafia is going to grab every single member of the Titans, throw them up against the wall, AK-47 blast them in the back and the spine and shit.
And shit. And
win.
I love the way you think, Fitz.
Bills Mafia, W.
What do you got, Fitz?
I like this game.
I do too.
I just think it's going to be a good matchup. You know, I really like Jonnu Smith, the tight end for the Titans. I think he might expose the Bills. I don't think the Bills really got the linebackers to cover him. I kind of like him for the middle. If he can get open and maybe open up the run game a tad for DH, I think it's going to be a close one, but I just don't see them being able to stop the Bills' high attack offense. John Brown and Stephon Diggs both have big playability to go over the top, and I think both of them will have a big touchdown. I'm thinking a 50-yarder to John Brown, a 60-yarder to Stephon Diggs.
Bold prediction.
And I think the Bills win 35-24.
All right, Cam, why don't you close us off?
And I'm going to make it I'm pretty sure this is a star frame again, because I'm
star frame!
$5 charity of your choice!
Because I'm all high on Josh Allen. Ever since he stepped into the league, I have thought he has been a good quarterback, and I am sticking to I think he is still a good quarterback and still can make good plays. You can see him in the arm, you can see him make plays with his feet if he even has to. So I'm liking it, and I'm going to stick with it.
All right, so we are 16 minutes and 13 seconds in, and we are already...
our second star frame.
Second star frame.
Wow.
Coming up next, we got a matchup that I'm down on personally. We got the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on the Houston Texans. Now, tomorrow I'm going to record a preview for this game, and I hate the Jaguars defense, and I think Deshaun Watson should do big things against the Jags defense, but the morale of the Texans should be down a little bit, and I'm hoping that just boosts the Jaguars' morale. So I'm going to take the Jags to beat the Texans. I think with the loss of Bill O'Brien, maybe just some entanglement, hopefully. Just get us a W. Get us a W. That's what I want. Jags beat the Texans. I'm going to say 34-27. Cole, who do you got?
And I'm locking this pick with the Texans.
You're going to lock? Wow.
Yeah, I'm locking the Texans.
Locking, wow. The game could have upset it, too. Wow.
Yep. I'm locking the Texans, man. I just had a feeling, man. I think Deshaun Watson, like you said, is going to do big things, and I don't think the Jags will keep up.
Not with Deshaun Watson. I don't think our defense can. I think our offense can score. Defense can't keep up. Wyatt, what do you got?
Let's see. What game was this?
The Jags and the Texans.
Jags and Texans?
Yes.
Oh, man. I'm not going to lie. I was pretty split on this game. But I want to side with you much for that same reason that I feel like they'd be demoralized. Just because they've had a bad schedule pretty much, man. They've had to go through hell essentially. But I think the Jags are gonna have stellar defense.
Yeah. Bold prediction of the week.
Bold prediction of the week. And for this, I'm gonna go for them to win, even though I split it in a weekly poll. So.
All right, Fitz, who do you got?
Really tight.
I am taking the Texans because the Texans, I think they're going to play for Romeo Crennel, their intern head coach. He is their DC. He was the DC. He's been their DC for like 5 years. He's ran that same crew for this whole time. They've been a top 15 unit every year, no matter the injuries or what has happened to them. They're playing good. They're going to play good for him. I think they're going to get a couple turnovers for him. I think the Texans blow out the Jags, and I think they win.
I'm hoping the offense could at least do something. Cam, who do you got?
Definitely going to have to choose the Texans on this. I don't got no faith in the Jaguars. Even though the Texans have not won a game, I'm still going to have to choose the Texans.
We'll see if the Jaguars' offense can compete. That's going to be the big question.
And Treeb
heading into this one.
Making it so we don't have another star frame.
Actually, why I picked the Jags too? So we got
did you really?
Yeah.
Yeah. So
I don't listen.
Yeah, we got a two. We got a two.
It happens.
We got a 2-3. So coming up next, we got the Baltimore Ravens and the Cincinnati Bengals, and I will pick the Ravens, but like
They're going to be all right.
I think it'll be a good game. I love Joe Burrow. I do. I liked him, like, before he killed the Jags. And he didn't even really kill the Jags. It was Joe Mixon. But, like, I like Joe Mixon. I mean, I like Joe Burrow a lot. And I think he's going to be... He's a future face of the franchise. This is a guy that I don't think I'm going to be wrong about. It's not going to be like a Josh Allen that I'm going to have to eat crow on later on.
I hope you do.
He's gonna be good, but I'm gonna have to take the Ravens. Cam, who do you got?
You know, I'm definitely gonna have to choose the Ravens on this one. Even though I want to choose the Bengals,
I'm pulling for them.
I really like the defense. Not gonna lie, the Ravens always have a struggle against the Bengals defense. But I'm just gonna have to go with the Ravens this one. They look too clean.
It's crisp and clean, unless they're playing Kansas City Chiefs. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Ravens as a lock. I just think the Ravens are going to beat them. I don't hate Joe Burrow. I think Burrow is, he plays turnover-free football, but I think it's going to not be enough to get the third down conversions enough to keep up with this team. I think the Ravens just beat them.
Alright, Colt, what about you?
I'm picking the Bengals as my upset.
I actually
think it's not like I'm picking this because this is the only one that could be an upset. Because I was looking through my things and, like, I circled the Bengals. And I was looking for an upset and I was like, that is an upset. Yeah. And I honestly think it'll happen, even though I don't like the Bengals.
Well, what about Joe Burrow, though? You like Joe Burrow?
He's okay.
Yeah. If you went anybody anywhere else, would you be a fan?
How about Maybe. Randy Bullock?
Randy Bullock, man.
He comes off that calf injury.
I can respect that man because he came in when Chris Boswell was sick like 2 or 3 years ago. We signed him for a few games. Didn't miss one field goal, dude. He won like 2 game winners. I remember one was against, at the time it was San Diego. And he might win the game for him, honestly. I think about it. I think a 53-yarder with 0 seconds on the clock to win the game.
For Randy Bullock.
He hasn't
overtime.
He literally has not missed since his calf injury in week one when he pulled it to miss the game.
In overtime, I think they'll win it.
That's
what I'm saying.
Randy.
I was really close to picking the Bengals in this one. That was very close. Wyatt, who do you got?
Ooh, I got the Ravens.
Yeah, are you playing conservative for this one?
Ooh, yeah, absolutely.
I like the way you think. All right, coming up next, we got an NFC South battle. And this one is really interesting for me, too. We got the Atlanta Falcons. We got the Carolina Panthers. Cameron, I want you to start off with this one. We got the Falcons, Panthers. Make some sense out of this one.
You know, this is going to be a really tough game for the Falcons. I honestly, it is, especially with the teams that they've played. They've put up a lot, and I mean a lot of points. If I remember right, I think they're like top 3 or top 2 in scoring, but they still lose every game. They almost put up like 20, 30, 40 points every single game, damn near. But they lose. And then Carolina, on the other hand, they just barely sneak those dubs. And they can't put more in. They can't put more than 35 points up. So on this one, I'm going to have to choose the Falcons to get their first win over Carolina this week.
That's fair. I do want to shout out Teddy Bongwater, though.
Oh, I love the guy.
I do. I love Teddy Bongwater as well. And the other day when Fitz and Barton were here and Cam was out here, we were talking about like stat leaders and top 10 in passing, and almost every top 10 in every QB stat, Teddy Bongwater's up there.
I know we helped him, that's for sure.
and I'm going to take the Falcons in this one, too, despite Teddy Bongwater. I mean, Matt Ryan, man, I have him as a fantasy QB. He deserves better, bro. Like, come on, let's get him a win. Let's get him a division win. So I'm going to take the Falcons in this one. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Panthers. They're coming off a good win against us. They've stacked up a couple wins. I think they're going to keep rallying. I think they're going to go for 3-2. I really like Teddy Bridgewater. He makes a lot of plays. He doesn't look
Bongwater.
Yeah, that is true. And he made some plays running with his legs, but he doesn't look to do that. He juked out a couple of our linebackers and scored like a 23-yard touchdown running. So, I mean, he's still got that going for him. I think Matt Ryan looked out of sync on Monday night. His receivers, he didn't look in touch with anybody. Calvin Ridley had zero catches for zero yards. And he was wide open for a touchdown in the end zone where Ryan wasn't even looking for him. I think Ryan's looks like garbage. It's demoralized. They play good. They always get high numbers for the first few weeks.
Great
but
fantasy
they lose.
Players.
Yep, great fantasy. But then 0-4, and they're demoralized, and they're going to keep losing these games. And I think Dan Quinn's going to get fired. That's my bold prediction. I think
after this week?
I think it's going to be before this game.
Before?
I think so. I think he's going to get fired. It's Monday night. I think they're going to fire
this
him.
This ain't Monday night. This is
no,
Sunday.
They played on Monday
night.
Oh,
okay.
And went to 0-4. I think he's going to get fired before this game starts by the next of the week.
All right, Wyatt, what do you got?
I got the Panthers.
Okay. What do you got? What do you like about that one?
I like that the Panthers is like black cap, because like, it's like Halloween season. You know what I mean?
Hey, there we go.
And I like that the Panthers is like it's like a black cat crossing the road, but if you see this black cat cross the road, like you might die.
And Teddy Bongwater. If you drink the Bongwater, you might
die. I like to think of that as the Panthers season.
Fair enough. Colt, who do you got?
Yeah, I'm not going to spend too much time on this. Falcons, I wish the best for them, but I don't think they get the dub here, man. I'm going to have to go with Teddy Bongwater and the Carolina Panthers.
All right, so we'll see if me and Cam kind of pull through taking the Falcons in this one. Coming up next, we almost... one thing I do want to say that we're very consistent on. This is the second week in a row that I've put timestamps. We almost hit every pick, like, on the minute. Like, it's almost very consistent. Like, 27, like, 0-0. That's crazy. We got the Chiefs and the Raiders. I like the Raiders. I like what they're doing. Chiefs are going 16-0, though, so I'm picking the Chiefs. Cole, who do you got?
I'm picking the Chiefs. I think this is going to be a really close game, really high scoring. It's going to be, like, best game of the week. It's going to be like the highest scoring game of this season. It's going to be something crazy, like 45-42.
Crazier than the Browns Cowboys?
Possibly.
Wyatt, let's go second. What do you got?
I'm picking the Raiders.
Oh, really? Okay. Why is that?
I just feel like, you know, like,
it's KC's time to lose, huh?
I mean, watching that game with, you know, the Chiefs and the
Patriots,
it's just, there's no reason their quarterback can play that bad, really, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, if that's what the Raiders get, they'll win.
All right. Cam, what do you got?
You know, I'm going to have to choose the Raiders as an upset win this week.
Damn, upset.
It's going to probably be a bold take for me, but I'm going to risk it for the biscuit to stay in the lead and those extra points. I'm liking it. You know, the Chiefs, they were struggling against the Patriots last week, especially, and that wasn't with Cam Newton. So, I mean, just imagine if they had Cam Newton and then they had to play with that. I mean, like, they were kind of struggling against their defense, against Patriots' defense, and the Raiders, they got their corners and everyone. They got more speed. Yeah, they're not as locked down, but they got more speed to keep up with the players. So I'm going to have to go with the Raiders on this one as my upset.
All right, Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Chiefs.
Thank you.
Mahomes is...
I felt all alone. I can't believe... Did you
pick? I chose the Chiefs.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I thought you picked the Raiders at first. I was damn.
3-2.
It's just... you know, Mahomes, no matter what, if they're going to be down at any point in this game, he'll have that turnaround, and he'll win.
Mm-hmm.
They're on this 13-game win streak right now. I don't think he gets snaps. I'm with Treeb. I just don't see any team beat him.
Yeah.
I think it's just because Mahomes doesn't make mistakes, and he turns it on.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even when I seen, like, he threw it into, like, triple coverage the other day, and Tyreek almost caught it. for a touchdown. It was like in the bread basket dropped, and I was like, this is ridiculous. So I just think he's overly good. I like Darren Waller. I like Josh Jacobs. I think it's going to be a shootout. I think they're playing for Gruden this year, but I think they're going to be a wild card team because the Chiefs are just too good. Chiefs with the win.
You know, the whole AFC West, I think, is interesting. So I like the Chargers, too.
I do. Yeah.
You know, Herbert's another QB, I think, down the line. I'm going to have
they're
to eat.
Top 10
eat,
offense right
I'm
going
to have
too.
To eat some crow about Herbert down the line, too, because I said some not so nice words about him entering the draft.
He's so green.
But that's because the Cougs beat his ass in college. Coming up next, we've got the Arizona Cardinals going up against the New York Jets. Fitz, let's start her off.
Well, if you have, I'll tell you right now, fantasy-wise, if you have Jamison Crowder, start him. We play 10 yards off of any play. We let them do whatever they want. If they want to run a curl, if they want to run a slant, any of the quick routes, they get the balls, they're going to get it. So if Flacco's starting, which I heard he might be because of Darnold's shoulder strain, I think they'll tear up our defense, but I think we're going to tear up their defense. I think the Cardinals will beat them by, I'm going to say 20.
So you got the Cardinals.
Yep.
All right, Cam, who do you got?
You know, this was a tough choice for me, but I'm going to have to go with the Cardinals this week. You know, I really wanted to choose the Jets. I'm thinking they might get their first win against them this week, but I don't know. I'm not liking what the Jets are putting down, so I'm going to put the Cardinals this week. Be safe.
The Jets are looking terrible. Wyatt, what do you got?
I'm going to have to go with the Arizona Cardinals this week. I think the Jets are one of the shitty teams, just like I think the Giants are one of the shitty teams.
New York is now producing a lot of talent. Cole, who do you got?
Told myself. I was mad at the Cardinals.
Yeah.
I was mad. Bryce got me hyped. I got mad at them.
That's how I feel about the Browns every year.
And I was like, I'm not picking the Cardinals. I'm not doing it, dude. And then I saw who they were playing. And I was like, I'll give the Cardinals one more chance. But if I get this one wrong, I'm not going to pick the Cardinals for the rest of the year.
Ooh, his bold take of the week. All right, I think we're all...
Don't F it up.
I think we're all not going to pick the Cards because this is going to be the third
Starframe $5 charity of your choice.
It took four more games before we got our third Starframe and our 25th of the year. But yeah, the Cardinals are going to win, and hopefully Kyler Murray gets back to looking like himself. In the last 2 weeks, he's kind of, I wouldn't say played scared, but he didn't look how he looked.
We can't be doing bubble screens and inside zones. Like, we got to open up the receivers and let them go downfield. We only took two deep shots, and they were both incomplete. It's simple as that. I don't think the Jets' secondary is good at all.
All right, so coming up next, we have the Steelers going up against the Eagles. Colg, I want you to take this one away.
Not going to lie. The Eagles looked all right last week, you know, on Sunday night. But what would I be doing here if I didn't pick the Steelers?
Exactly.
Right, man, so I'm just going to have to pick the Steelers. Just to hope. I mean, I think they can do it, man. We have a great defense, top-tier defense, an all right offense, and I think it'll just be enough to tackle down the Eagles.
All right, Wyatt, what do you got?
I got the Steelers and Big Bang.
That's fair enough, man. Bing, bang, boom. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Steelers. I liked what the Eagles did to the Niners, but the Niners are hurt. This Steelers team is legit. Their whole defense is good. I like Roethlisberger. I think this honestly helped them more than it hurt that this whole thing got flexed with the Titans. They got a bye week early when Connor was kind of hurting. Dave DeCastro just came back.
Mm-hmm.
It gives them a little bit more time to get fresh with each other. And I think this offense is going to be steamrolling. I'm thinking like 42-24. They're going to easily walk away with it. And I think Big Ben gets pulled.
Ooh.
I think he's just going to be chilling after a while.
You think old Mason's going to come in?
Yeah.
Throw a touchdown?
I think he's going to go 5-0. Big Ben's going 5-0. He's going to throw one to James Conner, one to the backup running back.
Mm-hmm.
And then one to Juju, one to Vance McDonald.
Oh, you think he's spreading it out.
And one to James Washington.
Treeb's boy.
I love James Washington. Cam, who do you got?
You know, I really liked what I saw against the Eagles last week. But Bryce is right. They were playing against a very hurt team. So I'm going to have to go with the Steelers to make it a...
Starframe!
$5 charity of your choice. And I'm just saying, we've all star-framed with the Steelers this year.
Have we?
Yeah.
No. There's one game I haven't chosen Steelers.
I thought...
Well, I have them all written mm-hmm. down, but... Yeah.
The most star-framed team, I feel like, might be Pittsburgh.
Dude, you know who I didn't get to get my pick in, but I'm also picking Pittsburgh.
Oh, sorry.
So,
I thought you went first.
I know, but I'm picking Pittsburgh. But you know who else I think has a lot of star frames is Arizona.
Arizona. Bryce gets us hyped up on Arizona. God damn it, Bryce.
I think Arizona.
To be honest, though, like, I just knew it with the Panthers last week. I could have told you. I just knew.
Yeah.
All right. Coming up next, we have the Rams going up against the Washington football team. Wyatt, why don't you go first on this one?
I picked the football team.
Oh.
Ooh, the football team.
Really? What do you like about that one?
Well, I like the L.A. football team.
Oh!
They're a really good football team. And I don't think they get much credit, even though they've been whitewashed, changed, and relocated.
Okay.
I think they will get a win. I think it will be a fairly impressive win. And they'll get to knock off a little bit of the dirt. And a lot of the grime and a lot of the rust.
Alright. Fitz, what do you got?
I'm going with the Rams. I hate my division.
Yeah.
I absolutely hate it.
Yeah.
Look at them again. The Rams, they'll just... It's plug and play, man. They had Gurley mm-hmm. for all these years. Now they're like, screw it. We don't care which back it is. We're still going 100 yards. We got Whitworth. We'll just run it. Okay. And then Cooper Kupp, Robert Woods, 100 yards here, 100 yards there, whatever. You know, just throw a couple routes here or there. Yep, 5-0 sounds good. Rams are going to get it done. I think Aaron Donald has 3 sacks. This offense, he's going to make Haskins look scared. Haskins mm-hmm. going to throw a couple picks. Ramsey's going to be ready to fight the next guy. He already took out Tate last week. He's going to be ready to go this week.
I'm also going to take the Rams, but this Rams team is going to be my lock of the week. I'm going to lock the Rams over the football team. Colt, you got?
Man, nobody puts respect on Jared Goff's name. No. I'm just saying, man. Have you ever heard...
I was a big Jared Goff
you
guy.
You were, but I feel like no one talks about him.
I'm a big
Jared Goff guy. I think he's fine.
Yeah,
he's not top-tier quarterback, but he is not a bad quarterback. And I'm choosing L.A., man. Because the Washington football team sucks asshole. Dude,
yeah.
I do not like Dwayne Haskins.
I love him.
And I'll never eat my pants over that one. Or what do you say?
Eat crow.
Eat crow.
All right, Cam, let's see if you can close it off.
I'm going to have to go with the Rams on this one.
For another
Starframe!
$5 charity of your choice.
And what do you like about the Rams in this one?
You know, just Jared Goff, he is looking pretty good, you know, and all the receivers in the run game. Everything just in general is looking, I'm liking it. And Washington just, they're not looking good at all. I honestly feel like if Alex Smith is still playing, correct? And he's still with the Redskins, is still with Washington, correct?
Okay.
Yeah, I feel like by the week 8, he will start playing.
Hopefully he's 100% good.
He is.
He is 100%.
Is he?
He's 100% cleared. He was cleared by training camp earlier this year.
He even padded up. I seen week 1, he was like in the crowd.
He was padded up.
Oh, was he?
Yep, at training camp, so he is good to go.
I love the guy. I love Alex Smith.
I think he could get that team over the hump in that division.
Mm-hmm.
Because
they'll start winning games when they put him in.
The Eagles are winning the division with 1.5 wins. they're literally the... Yeah, that's ridiculous. If you put Alex Smith in, that's a playoff. They're going to the playoffs.
I can't believe that, honestly. That's a wild division. We're living in wild times. Coming up next, we have the Miami Dolphins going up against the San Francisco 49ers. And I'll start this one off. I love Ryan Fitzpatrick. We all love Ryan Fitzpatrick.
We love the guy.
Ryan Fitzpatrick's the man. Ryan Fitzpatrick's the GOAT. And that is why, even if Jimmy Garoppolo is starting this week, I'm picking Miami as my upset of the week to defeat San Francisco 49ers. I'm going to fuck with it. I'm going to say Myles Gaskin gets 100 yards. I'm going to say he does what he needs to do. And I'm going to say the defense does just enough. Injuries on the Niners maybe plaguing them just a little bit too much. So my upset of the week is going to be Miami over the Niners. Wyatt, who do you got?
I was also going to pick the Dolphins for my upset of the week. I'm picking Fitzmagic. It's going to run absolutely wild. It's going to be great to see. And I cannot wait for Sunday night. Evening. Or morning.
Colg, who do you got?
I got the 49ers, man. I don't think the Dolphins got it in them. I don't think they got enough fight left in them.
See, this is one of those games, man. You gotta reach. You gotta look for your teams to pick, and that's I had to pick it. Cam, who do you got?
You know, on this one, I'm not too sure. Kind of wasn't really paying attention on this one. Their partner was kind of looking at my fantasy drafts right there. That's
Dolphins and Niners.
But I'm definitely going to have to go with the 49ers on the lock.
A lock of the week on the Niners. A flip-flop of me and Wyatt. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Niners. The Dolphins have been playing hard football. They kept in it with the Bills. They kept in it with the Seahawks. They're going to keep in it with the Niners. But the Niners are going to give them too much. The Niners win it. Easy peasy. Jimmy G's coming back with 3 TDs.
The Dolphins are going to get a face full of pillow.
Dude. Oh, no.
Yeah.
From Jimmy G Curtis.
Jimmy G. Exactly, that handsome man.
Face full of pillow courtesy of Jimmy G. I know a couple of females that would love to get that experience. Coming up next, we got the NFC East matchup between the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. We talked about how shitty the NFC East is, and it is garbage. But Dallas is a little less garbage, and I seen a post the other day about possible MVP candidates, and Dak Prescott was up there. I mean, if Dak Prescott, if they can go to the playoffs, maybe.
MVP for going 1-3?
I know, but I mean, maybe. He throws a lot of yards. I don't know. Probably not. But I also seen a meme where it was like, Dak Prescott throws 400 yards and the defense loses, and then everybody's like, oh my god, Dak sucks, and it's that one meme with the guy with the rope around his neck, and it has Romo, and it's like, first time. And, you know, that's just how Dallas fans are. But I'm going to take the Cowboys to beat the Giants. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Cowboys. The Giants are just not a good enough team anymore. They just, Saquon's out, and it's just, there's nothing left of that team to shell. I think Daniel Jones, I think it's going to be the race to see which team's going to get Trevor Lawrence. I think it's going to be either New York team for next year. So I'm taking the Cowboys, and it's going to be by a lot.
All right, Wyatt, what do you got?
I feel like I'm going to go with Cowboys here. Although I empathize with Daniel Jones. Because I feel like he's a good quarterback, you know. Hear me out. I feel like with a great team, with a better team, not the Giants, I feel like he could prosper somewhere else. But I'm just saying.
I doubt it. Cam, who do you got?
You know, I'm definitely gonna have to go with the Cowboys on this one. I really don't have faith in the other team. And just not going to be too good.
Do you know who the other team is?
Yes, I do.
The Giants.
Yeah.
No.
There you go. All right, Colg, who do you got?
Man, I got the Cowboys. The Giants suck. Daniel Jones sucks. Starframe. $5 charity of your choice.
All right. Starframe number 6 of this video. And coming up next, if I can get to my notes here, we have the New England Patriots going up against the Denver Broncos. Cam, tell me how the Patriots are going to rebound this week.
You know, Cam Newton, as it has been as of right now, he is still out. And, you know, I'm not really liking what Brian Hoyer put. As you can tell, he got benched in the fourth quarter and Stidham stepped in. And I really think they're really going to stick with Jarrett as their starting quarterback, and they really should. He is a solid quarterback. Yes, he doesn't know the system as well as Brian, but Brian is absolute dog trash. I have no faith in the guy, and no one does. That's why he's been on the team for so long. But last week was his first starting game as a New England quarterback, and that just proves how bad he is. But I do have faith in my team, and they are going to come back. And I do believe they're going to beat the Broncos in this one there. So I'm going to have to choose the Patriots on this one.
All right, Larry, who do you got?
I'm taking the Patriots. I just think they, you know, they're obviously they looked bad because it's Brian Hoyer. I've seen that train come through Arizona before, and I've been through that QB carousel dealing with that. Cam's, I've heard, supposed to be cleared by Thursday.
He's supposed to be cleared by Thursday.
I'm going to go with the Patriots, even if it's Stidham or him. I think they're going to win by a lot. The Patriots defense is that good. I would love to see the boat get out there because I really don't think any other quarterback in the Broncos, other than Drew Lock, who's out for weeks, is going to do it.
I would also like to see the boat, and whether it's Steidham, Hoyer, or Newton, I think the Patriots also won this one. Colt, who do you got?
I got the Patriots. The Broncos just suck, dude. Just Bats. Like the last 4 or 5 games I just predicted, the Broncos suck, man.
Facts.
Why do you got to close this out?
I'm riding with Steidham and Hoyer and any other New England Patriot quarterback they got.
Starframe!
$5 charity of your choice.
Right here, we're getting a run. We're getting a run of some Starframes.
Gotta go with them Riots, my man.
We're all gonna either gonna do really good this week or
really
bad.
That's what I was just thinking.
Alright, coming up next, here we got the Cleveland Browns and the Indianapolis Colts, bro. And this is...
Well, you better start off with me, I think.
Yeah, I think that's probably the go-to. So, I mean, make some sense out of this, man. Convince me at least.
All right, so here's the deal. Dallas has never been good. They're like... Dallas. Yes.
They're mediocre. They're good. They're not great.
Oh, you're talking about Dallas
against Cleveland.
Sorry,
the Cowboys. I'm talking the Cowboys, all right? They are like TLC football, all right? They're commercialized, all right? They're not that great. So the fact that Cleveland beat them is good. That means they're an average team. So now they're average like Colts, you know what I mean? They Colts are more subpar. They kind of reached the subpar level, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So now the Colts are going to give them a run for their money. Going to beat them, you know what I mean? It's going to be 1-0 Colts. Phillip Rivers isn't going to throw any picks, maybe one pick. It's not going to matter. They're not going to be able to do anything.
Alright.
Even if they put the game in their hands, Baker Mayfield will fuck it up.
Cam, what do you got?
How about that one? A little mid-yawn.
I didn't catch it until you started.
You know, I really wanted to choose the Colts on this one. I really do. But I have no faith in the Browns. But at the same time, I'm not really liking what the Colts are putting down. They are struggling, and I mean they are struggling to get their wins, if they do get their wins. And the Browns, you know, not gonna lie, they're looking pretty good, but at the same time, they are still looking pretty bad in their quarterback situation, and they still gotta get that fixed. But I think they're gonna have it still. I think they're gonna have it keep it rolling with the Browns, and I'm gonna have to go with that.
All right, Cole, what do you got?
The Browns will only have one good game every 4, 5, 6 games, and I don't think this will be one of them. I think it's going to be the Colts by a lot.
All right, Fitz.
I'm taking the Browns. I took the Colts in the other one, but on my other one, but I think the I could see it going either way. The Colts defense is number one in the run, but I think this offensive line for the Browns is on a whole nother level. I don't think it matters who's running behind them. I think all purpose, I think Kareem Hunt and D'Ernest Johnson are going to get 250 yards all purpose, rushing, receiving, whatever they do in that offense. I think the Colts and the Browns are going to be in a close one, but the Browns are going to win by a field goal.
I'm also going to take the Browns, and I think Kareem Hunt in this game is going to kind of remind people why he was a premier back for Kansas City before he got into that trouble. And Kareem Hunt, I think, throughout the season has kind of shown glimpse of that potential of where he was. And, you know, he's been sharing those carries with Chubb with the open arms. He's been saying, hey, you know, this is our team, this is our opportunity, we're going to lead this offense. He's been doing it. And I like the offense. I also think Cleveland's pass defense doesn't get enough credit. They have so many dropped interceptions. I've watched a good amount of Browns games just because every time I go over to Fitz's house, it's on in the other room, and I got to go back and forth between the two games. And I have seen so many dropped interceptions by the Browns, so I think their pass defense is pretty good.
I got to save Cameron, though. As far as win goes, we are 3-1. The only people who beat us are the Jags.
And I called that.
And that's on gang. I didn't
Me
pick,
and you.
I didn't
Yeah,
pick
but those
it.
Wins are struggles. You are struggling, and you struggled against the Jags, and you lost against the Jags. Then teams before.
Well, that was week one, though.
Yeah, you lost against them, man. I can't choose a team when they lose to the Jags.
That's a fair point. All right, Colg. I'm gonna be pretty fucking blunt with you right now.
I've been weak lately.
I know. I have been waiting for a hitter. Week one was a hitter. Week two, you got down like 10%. Week three, you dropped like 40%. And week four might have been the worst performance you have given on the channel. I'm telling you, dude, 2019, they were bangers on bangers on bangers.
Now you just fucking suck.
And now you're just giving me fucking Life of Pablo.
Well, it's because I quit smoking.
That's probably why. Your singing went down the second that you stopped smoking.
Seriously, probably. Okay.
Oh.
Okay. Sunday night! That was bad, too.
I felt the passion. The problem got better from last week, I would say.
Yeah, last week sucked. This week sucked. I sucked.
This week's getting better.
Man, you're bad.
But I also feel like you're rushing it.
I know. Because you just put me on the spot there.
Well, you
man.
Know, because you, but you gotta know.
Yeah, you gotta know when someone
last two games.
Well, yeah, I was practicing it yesterday. I had some good ones after like the third or fourth or fifth one.
You should have grabbed a bottle of water. I am your age, and I should have supplied you with a bottle of water.
I should have took a freaking drag off of a cig.
Yeah, maybe we should pause the podcast.
And go smoke.
Smoke break. Do a smoke break. We're already 53 minutes in. We might as well. Did you want a second go at it?
No, I'm not allowed to. Yeah,
nope.
No,
next week.
This is a one fucking take podcast, if you can't tell. All right. And Sunday night, we got the Seahawks taking on the Vikings. The Vikings finally came into their own a little bit, kind of. But I ain't buying it. I don't think anybody else should buy it. The Seahawks are on a whole new level. Russell Wilson's the MVP of the league right now, for my money. And I'm going to take the Seahawks. Colg, who do you got?
I'm choosing the Seahawks for the exact same reason. I love the Vikings. Wish the best for them. But Seahawks are probably going to win at least by 21 points.
Wyatt, who do you got?
I'm picking the Seahawks, best team west of the Mississippi.
We established that last week. Cameron, who do you got?
You know, I'm going to have to choose the Seahawks on this one. They're just looking real good as a team.
All right, and Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Vikings for my upset of the week. I think they're going to rally off that win last week. I know it was just the Texans, but it feels good to get a win under their belt. They always play hard against the Seahawks. Every time they ever play, it's in a barn burner.
Here.
And I think this team, the Seahawks secondary, they have not been covering receivers very well. I think Justin Jefferson has filled in wonderfully for the role of Stephon Diggs. I think he's going to tear up the Seahawks team. I think Adam Thielen's going to tear up the Seahawks team. Maybe Rudolph gets a touchdown too. I think it's going to be a barn burner. I think Seahawks, obviously, Russ will keep up, but I'm going to say the Vikings get him.
All right.
Interesting.
Colt, who do you got?
Seahawks. I already chose
Seahawks. Did we all hit?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you avoided the Starframe, yep. Cunt. I was waiting to
hey,
sing.
Don't worry, I was going to choose the Vikings, too. I was literally anxious. Yep. On my phone, I have the Vikings, but as you said my name, I was like, fuck it, I'm going to have to choose the Hawks on this one.
I was literally, the only reason I went back to Colg was because I was so sure that one was going to be a Starframe. All right, and for the final game of the week, we got the Chargers going up against the Saints. Fitz, who do you got?
I'm taking the Saints. Michael Thomas will be back this week. I think that, you know, having him back in that offense is going to reopen it up for Drew Brees. I do like Justin Herbert. I think I loved watching him answer against Brady. Brady threw a touchdown, then he threw a 72-yard dart to a guy who I've never even heard of. But I love that answer from Herbert. I think he's going to do that same type of thing with Brees. I think it's going to be tit for tat for touchdowns. But I think the Saints get him. Because Thomas opens that offense up. Kamara's going to have, I think, 150 yards for all-purpose. He's had 13 catches for 135 yards and a touchdown. And that was just catching. So I think he'll get back into running since Michael Thomas is back in.
So originally I had the Saints written down. And then I switched it to the Chargers. And then I went to you to pick first. And then you said Michael Thomas is back. And then I switched it back to the Saints as soon as I heard that news.
He practiced all of last week but did not play, so I'm guessing he's getting to be.
Yeah, so I hear that. Justin Herbert, man, that's a... Like I said earlier, other guy's wrong about. I mean, he's looking good. Went tit for tat.
You're honestly wrong about a lot of guys. And when you say you're right, they're usually really bad.
Oof.
Like Fitzpatrick. Joe Burrow.
I never
hype up QBs. I just recap games.
I only hype up QBs because the Jags are always in the market for one. Cool, who do you got?
I got the Saints. I think Thomas has... He only has 75 receiving yards, but he has 3 catching touchdowns. Alvin Kamara has 100 rushing and 100 receiving with 3 touchdowns.
Fitz? I mean, not Fitz. Wyatt?
I'm going to have to go with Breeze and the Saints when they go marching in at St. Louis.
Los Angeles.
Fucking Los Angeles.
They're at the Superdome.
They're at the Superdome, man.
Ooh.
So the Saints are just going to walk across the street.
Yep.
Walk around the facility. Get the dub. Cam, who do you got?
I'm going to have to go with the Saints on this one. Justin didn't really put up the what I liked against the Patriots, so I'm going to have to go with the Saints on this one.
All right, and to end the video, that was a...
Starframe! $5 charity of your choice.
Racked them up today. Last week, we had 6 Starframes. This week, we had
9.
A total of 8.
Wow, you need to learn how to count, bud.
We had 8 this video.
Yeah, we had 8 star frames.
Damn.
This week.
Oh, we're popping off.
So again, this is either going to be a really good week for us or a really bad week for us.
Still think I'm going to be in the lead, and I did my calculations, Matt, at the very beginning. I said I had 35 points, and then at the very end when I said I had 45, 35 plus 13 does not equal 35. That does equal 48.
I think you said 48.
He said
45,
but it does equal 38. So
you mean 48.
Yeah, 48. But. If you guys know what I mean, it's 48. Yeah. I was just not thought about it. I was like, wait, what?
So. All right. And on that, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to do it for the NFL Week 1's picks, locks, and upsets. Colg, any final words?
No, I just hope you guys have the best day of your life.
Fitz.
Ditto.
Maybe one day I'll get good at Sunday night again.
Make Colg great again, dude.
Hashtag, yeah, exactly.
He's a vet.
Hashtag, vote for Colg.
Vote for Colg in the 2020 election. Cam, any final words?
I hope Colton finally says the Sunday night song right.
And Wyatt, any words to close it out?
Alright. So, if you ever challenge me to bowling and you can't score at least 200 points, get the fuck out of my face.
Dude, you are not that good at bowling. There's no way.
I'm a fucking legend.
Maybe on the Wii Sports, there's no way you're that good at bowling.
300's perfect, right? 200's par, bro.
Dude, I challenge... 150 would be par.
I don't know.
I challenge you.
I challenge you. All right, next week on NFL Picks.
We're bowling. Live at the bowling
alley. I would be closer.
Three talks.
I'd be closer to 200 than you.
Why
ran
off to the crane machine? Is he trying to win cheap headphones or a wristwatch?
All righty, guys. Thank you guys so much for listening to this episode of NFL Picks. If you guys did, go ahead, make sure you drop a like down below and hit that subscribe button, click the bell icon so you're always notified. If you haven't already, you can check out the links down below. You can like me on Facebook, at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Twitter, at Treeb Talks, or follow me on Instagram, at Trey Vaughn Pixley. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and as always, you guys have a great rest of your day.